Hey guys, welcome back. It's Dee from SimplyDeeBeauty. I'm really excited for today's video because I am going to use for the first time on my eyes the new Dior Holiday collection, Atelier of Dreams. I bought one of the quints and also two of the lipsticks and also the blush. So I'm really, really excited to try. I have nothing on my face right now. All I applied was some moisturizing primer, some Bobbi Brown Vitamin C Enriched Base. I usually wear that under my makeup. And I have some lip balm because I am going to be swatching two other lipsticks. And I like to do that as I do my makeup to be, you know, nourishing my lips before I put on any makeup. So because I am going to be talking about the new Dior Holiday collection, I want to do sort of like a full face Dior. So everything else I'm going to use on my face today is Dior. But first, before I do anything on my face, let me show you what I got. I did order directly from the Dior website, and I already opened it and did a video on it and took some photos for Instagram, so I don't have the ribbon on or nothing like that, but it was beautifully packed. I do invite you to go to my Instagram so you could check out my stories and my highlights. I have it saved there under the Dior highlights section. So let's open up this baby. I did get the blush from Saks Fifth Avenue, and then the rest I got from directly from the Dior website. So this is what it looks like inside. And let me take them out one by one. Let me show you first the quint that I got. I got the 469 Atelier Doré, which is the golden one. And I just want to show you how beautiful it's the design. It's like the front of the store. I'm not sure. I believe I read somewhere that it's kind of reminiscent of the original Dior store in Paris. Right now the name of the street escapes me. So it's really, really pretty. I don't use these applicators, so I might as well just remove them. And I'll do a swatching later before I apply it on my face. I also got the blush. Also has like the same design. I swiped it already. I swatched it for Instagram, so part of it is already gone, but you see how beautiful it is. And for the swatching, I noticed that it's sort of like a blush topper, not exactly a blush. So I'm going to use it as a topper in this video, but it's beautiful. And I also got two other lipsticks. They came out with four new ones, at least of this design. They came out with four. I got two of them, the 074 Rose D'Hiver and 075 Rouge Capuchin. Again, I'll do the swatching right before I apply them. So, and I also got some samples. I got some perfume samples, little ones, but I do want to show you a Mini J'adore Infinisime perfume, and it's just beautiful. It's so cute, and I wanted to show you guys, so I'll put that aside. And it did come, the samples came in a little really cute cloth bag, which I'm going to keep. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is apply foundation. And I'm going to use a Dior Forever Skin Glow, one of my favorite foundations. For me, in my opinion, is for my skin is a little bit more full coverage than I'm used to. It is a little bit dewy, so I'm just going to apply it on half my face first, and then you'll see the difference on my skin. So let's start with this much. I'm using the Beekeeper 101 brush. I forgot to mention that with the purchase that I did in the Dior, I also got a free Dior brush set. I am going to show it to you guys now, but I think I'm going to put it aside for the future giveaway that I am putting together because I'm already past 500 on YouTube. So in advance, I want to thank everybody who supports me. I will be having a giveaway real soon, and I'm getting everything together to show you, to do a video and show you everything that I'm giving away. And I'll show you the gift now once I apply the foundation. It has a slight scent, but it's not too strong. It's not overpowering. So this foundation gives a really pretty glow. It's not, like I said, it's not full coverage, but for me it's more full than what I'm used to. So there you see it on half of my face. It gives me really soft, radiant look, which I really like. And then you see on the other half, my redness is there. So I'm going to cover it up now. And then on this side, I don't have anything. It looks very natural. So now I do my other half. So now for concealer, I'm going to use the Forever Skin Correct. Well, by the way, the foundation is in the shade 1N. And the concealer is in the shade 1CR. I said I was going to show you the brush set. Let me show you before I forget. It's a huge box. It's really, really pretty. It's huge. It comes with four brushes and it has also a holder. I'm not gonna take it out because I want to leave it as intact as possible. Okay, so now I'm gonna apply the concealer. One of my favorite concealers as well. Dior is one of my favorite brands, so a lot of their things are like my favorite. Like one of my favorite foundations, one of my favorite concealers, one of my favorite mascaras. They're just wonderful. And you don't need a lot of concealer. I'm going to use a Beekeeper Beauty A506, the one that came out in the collab with Angie Hot and Flashy. It's a wonderful concealer brush. And I'm just going to go like this under the eyelid very softly. This brush is really fluffy and applies concealer flawlessly. The excess I'm gonna apply it on the lid and it's gonna serve as a primer. Okay, so now I'm gonna set the concealer and the foundation. I'm gonna use the Dior Professional Performance Perfecting Translucent Powder in the shade Neutral, Zero N or Zero Neutral. I am going to use a Beekeeper Beauty 105. Swirl it and just apply, especially all over the face, but especially over the eye area, because that's where I have the concealer. I love this powder as well. It does take off a little bit of the radiance, but not a lot, just a little bit, and it makes sure that the foundation and the concealer don't budge. So now I'm gonna go into the eyeshadow and then I'll do the bronzer and highlighter and blush, all that after. I'm just dying to get into the quint. So I did do a swatching for Instagram. I'm gonna do another one for you guys to show you again. This is what the quint looks like. It is beautiful, as the Dior eyeshadow formulas are. My favorite quint at the moment, because I still have to try this one on my eyes, is the Mitza. I love that quint. It's gorgeous. I'm gonna do it in the back of my hand. Only swiped it once. And then here you see the four main shades, and then this is the gold in the middle. Hopefully the camera picks it up. Beautiful formula. It looks like it's three satins or four satins, and then that dark brown is more matte, but it does have, yeah, that dark brown is a matte, and then we have three satins, and then the gold is more like a shimmery satin. So let's apply it on the face. I'm gonna try to use all of the five shades on this look. I'm gonna start with this shade right here. This is gonna be my crease shadow. I'm gonna start with a fluffy brush from Beekeeper Beauty again, the A503. But I feel bad using the shadows because eventually the beautiful design is gonna be erased, but you know, it is what it is. No fallout. So I'm gonna start here in the crease. Beautiful gold shimmer. With the same brush, since I already applied on the other eye, I am going to go in with this darker brown and go back to that same place where I applied the other one here on the crease and go over it. I have hooded eyes, as I usually say on my videos, so I like to go a little bit over the crease or right here where the brow bone starts. Okay, now I'm gonna find a more dense brush. I'm gonna use this Beekeeper Beauty 205, which has an angle to it. And maybe I'm gonna grab this shade right here and apply it on the outer half. And I'm gonna use then this darker shade in the waterline. I'm gonna start slow and then build it up as I go. So I'm gonna go right here in the corner and then go in within the crease area and right here on the lid and merge them together right here. I don't like really harsh lines. I like things to be blended, so that's what I'm trying to do here too. I'm gonna go back for some more and build it up to make it more intense. So beautiful. I'm gonna do now the other eye, and then I'm gonna grab a clean brush and fluff out the edges. With that brush I used before, I am going to grab some of this one again softly, and I'm gonna go in here in the inner half and try to blend it in here in the middle. Now, without getting any more shadow, I'm gonna get that same brush and fluff out here the edges. Now there's a little bit of fluff here, but I'll pick that up. I'm gonna go in with this one right here again and apply here on the edge. Not too close to the eyebrow, just right here on the edge. I think they're so pretty. I'm going to use my finger now and I'm going to apply some of that gold and apply it in the inner half. I still have some left on my finger, so I'm gonna grab a little bit for the brow bone right here. It's gonna be like a highlight. I'm just loving these shadows. They are so pretty. Perfect now for the holiday, to go out to dinner. Let me fluff these out. I think it's so luxurious and so pretty. I'm gonna grab a smop brush from Beekeeper, the A504, and I'm gonna get now that matte that I didn't use. This one has a little bit of fluff, so I gotta be careful, and put it on the outer half. Let me swipe clean this brush. I should have done the light part first, but that's all right. I wanna clean it, and I'm gonna go in with this really light, this lighter shade here, and apply it on the inner half, and then blend it in the middle. I'm gonna grab some of that gold and apply it here. My shadows are done. It is so pretty, so luxurious. I did get some fallout here, but I am gonna grab a clean fluffy brush, like this one from Beekeeper, the 108, which is clean, and I'm just gonna swipe it here, take off any specks that fell off, and with the brush I applied that concealer, I'm gonna go back in and just tap in lightly. And there you go. So now I'm going to apply the Dior Show. It's not new, but it's a lovely mascara. And I'm going to apply it now on the eyes, just to finish off the eyes. Okay, so eyes are done. Now we're gonna go into bronzer and blush and highlighter. All Dior. So I'm gonna start with the bronzer. This is the light bronze. It all comes in this really pretty packaging. I'm gonna use the new blush as a topper because it does have a really, really light shimmer. I'll show you now when I swatch it, but let's start with a bronzer. My shade is the light bronzer, or light bronze in shade 02. I'm going to grab a Sony G smooth buffer that, in my opinion, is one of the best brushes to apply bronzer. So I'm just gonna apply it in the normal places where I usually wear bronzer, just here under the cheek area and around the forehead. It just gives me a really light bronze look, which I like. And I'm gonna get a little bit and apply here under the neck. Give me a nice look. And now I'm gonna go into the blush. I'm gonna use as a blush, this is the Core Glow. It is sold as it's called a Couture Luminizer. It's intense highlighting powder, but I use it as a blush. I'm going to grab a Wayne Goss the artist brush. This is like the middle size one. Actually, I'm gonna grab the bigger size of the three. And I'm just gonna grab a little bit. It's a beautiful, beautiful shade. And I'm gonna just apply here on the cheek area. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to apply this one on one side, and then I will apply the new one on the other side so you guys could see the difference, how it will look by itself. This is what it looks like. It is very pretty. It's called Hologram, the 601. So this is what it looks like. It's very like a light shimmer. It really is not that intense. Let me get a little bit more. So that's why I think it should be used as a blush topper and not as a blush. It does have a slight shimmer to it. So I'm gonna grab that same brush, I'm gonna turn it around, and I am going to apply this on the other side of my face, on my other cheek. It does pick up nicely with this brush. So I think I picked a little bit too much. I'm gonna go really slow. Oh yeah, it has like a little bit of like purple in it, maybe a little too shimmery for my taste, and it's a shade that I personally don't like. But there you see how it looks by itself. You see it has like a purple shift to it, which I'm not a fan, so I'm going to mix it up with the other one that I applied before on the other cheek. Yeah, definitely it's a color that I don't like. It has like too much purple in my taste, too much pink. And this one I do like a little bit more. It does have a shimmer, but I think it's a prettier shade. So I'm gonna get the foundation brush and then just press it on a little bit. Kind of remove some of that blush. A little bit better. A little bit. And I'm gonna go back with that other color and see if I can make it better. I definitely prefer this side. So now I'm gonna go in with highlighter. To finish off the face, I am going to use this shade, which I love. It's the Golden Glow number 04. There's a lot of pickup here, so I'm going to go really careful. See how pretty? Let me show you this side. Really pretty, really subtle, very natural looking. And I'm going to go and apply some here. So there it is. Maybe a little bit too pink, more pink than what I am used to or what I like. I'm more into a peachy coral blushes, but I am trying out a new product, so it's good to see it side by side with another product. I personally am not a fan of this blush because it does give, like, in my opinion, it gives like a little bit of a purple, a lilac kind of hue, which I don't like. But I think if I were to pick up a little bit less with a brush, I could apply over a blush that doesn't have any shimmer, because this one does have shimmer. Apply another, like a matte blush, and then apply that one as a topper, I think will be better than just like that by itself. But it's not that bad. It's pretty. And the design is really pretty as well. So now we're going to go into the lipsticks. And like I showed you, I got two of them. I got the 074 and the 075. The 074 is called Rose d'Hiver, which, if my French is still there, Hiver is winter, I believe. So it's, I guess, winter, pink winter, winter pink, something like that. And it is a beautiful shade. Let me swatch in the back of my hand. I'm going to use this one. Oh, let me show you the design. Very again, it's like the quint. It does have like the design of the storefront. I think it's beautiful, and it did have the initials, but since I've already swatched it, it's probably gone. Yeah, it's gone. It did have the CD, the initials on the top of the bullet, and it's just so pretty. Let me swatch on the back of my hand to show you. They're so creamy and buttery. And then I'm gonna swatch it now on my lips, of course. The other one is 075, is Rouge Capuchin. This one, you can still see it, the CD slightly. Let me see if the camera focuses. You can still see it. There's still some of it left. And then the same design of the bullet. Let me swatch it as well. So this one on the left is 074, Rose d'Hiver, and 075, Rouge Capuchin. They do have a scent, typical of other Dior lipsticks, which I personally like. They're so pretty. I think I'm gonna swatch this one first, although it's the darkest, and then I'm going to swatch this one second, because it's the one I wanna keep for today's look. So let's start with this one. So here's Rouge Capuchin. They do dry matte. They're matte, but they don't feel matte. They feel so nice on the lips, so creamy. It's a beautiful, I would say it's like a rustic orange with some red in it. It is a beautiful color that it has like a pretty shimmer. Not a shimmer, that's not the word I'm looking, like a radiance. It's just gorgeous. Beautiful shade. It feels so creamy on the lips, although it is matte. I love it. I think it looks great. But I have to take it off because I do want to show you guys the other one. Okay, so now we're going to go into Rose d'Hiver. So this one is, of course, less intense, but it's still a beautiful shade. It is a rose, like the name implies. It's like a a musty pink, for lack of another word. It's a pink, but it has some brown in it, and again it has like some radiance just like the other one, but I like the other shade better because the color is more of my taste. But this color is very pretty, and I think it looks good. In my personal opinion, I like when I do smoky eyes or an more intense eyeshadow look or eye look, I like to go with a more subtle lipstick. And when I do it the other way around, I like to go with a bold red when I have very subtle eye look. So for this look, I think I prefer this lipstick, although I do like the other shade better. I hope that makes sense. So yeah, I like that shade better, but for this look, I prefer this lipstick actually, because it draws more attention to the eyes. I think it's beautiful. Beautiful formula, beautiful lipstick, beautiful eyeshadows. Everything is beautiful. The topper was a little bit not of my taste, but I think everything else was or is gorgeous. I didn't do my eyebrows, but I don't have a Dior eyebrow product. I usually use my Charlotte Tilbury Legendary Eyebrows, but I do want to keep it Dior. So, except the primer was Bobbi Brown, but the makeup, everything was Dior. So this is my video for you guys today. I was very excited to share these items with you and try them on for the first time with you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know in the comments below if you picked up anything from the Dior 2021 holiday collection, the Atelier of Dreams. Let me know if you picked up anything, if there's anything that you liked or disliked, anything you liked or disliked from this look. I'd love to hear from you guys. I'm gonna leave the links of everything I've used today in the description box. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't done so already. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.